hello everyone. So all we're going to do today is go through a sort of scenario-based net. So obviously there's loads of different options you could do, but today we're going to focus on spin. Reason being is because that's potentially not something we do very often, and I think it'd be a good idea to exhibit that and also how we can go about that as coaches, but also as players saying up to each other. So the scenario we've given ourselves is 20 overs, 6 to 10, so just after the power play, so Moorfield is out. And then we're going, we are setting total and the team is 40 for two. So a bit of imagination, but it will mean we have context. And then I'm going to say 7 and over would be about par in a 20 over game. And so we're going to put that as the target. So 24 balls, 28 needed and 2 wickets left. We've got a right-handed batter in Mr. Darlow. And then also we've got our field here. So just to briefly touch on it, you're allowed 5 players out. I've put those in positions where I think I can bowl to, but also where I'm trying to limit Mr. Darlow in terms of what he's trying to do. So just your thoughts, sir, like what do you think you're going to do? What's your game plan looking at it?
Initially, probably between 6 and 8 overs. Just looking to knock it around 7 over. You don't have to go massive. It doesn't have to be a boundary every over. So I'd personally be looking as a base theory, either get right forward to the pitch or get right back on your stumps. Allow yourself to work around the corner or hit down the ground. That would be my initial 2 scoring zones. So sort of through square leg here or back down the ground here for an easy single. Maybe if you time it or hit it at the right pace, you could get 2. And then just back myself in my zones. So my zone for me would be sort of in and around this area where I can allow the back path to come through. And if we're at BMS, like it says at the top, if you back yourself to clear the ropes, there's no point in holding back. That'll be my entry theory. So knock it round, if it's in your zone, back yourself.
Yeah, I love that about your zone and knowing your game. It's really good. So we're going to get into it. We'll film a couple of things, and then about halfway through, we'll come back in, have a little chat, and see where we are. Five or six. So 14 off 12, so hitting that target that we talked about. So you spoke about your game plan. Just take me through the innings then.
Well, you saw there was one where I felt it was in my zone, so give it the full shebang, but then everything else was 1-1-1. Wherever it is, just work it. Now, I missed out on a couple short and wide, which annoyingly I hadn't thought about. There's no third man, so that's another scoring option that I could factor in. But just playing to your strengths of there or down the ground, easy as that, and you can go sevens quite comfortably. So
were you premeditating that big shot I talked about? Because I felt as a bowler, I felt like there was going to be a big shot there, so I sort of threw it up a bit more.
Yeah, I guess I didn't premeditate, but for me, as soon as I saw the ball go up, I was that was my chance to really go, because there wasn't really anything in that area there where you can sort of release yourself and the back path come through. It was all right back or right forward, but as soon as I got one there, then I just backed myself, whether it was 4 or 6 as an argument's sake, or whether you get caught in a deep, but as long as you get the intent there, I think that's the main thing.
Yeah, brilliant. I think it's like having that plan as well, like you said, it's almost going, if it's in this area, I'm going to play this shot, and that's what it looked like there, it really clear is where you're wanting your forward.
So. Yeah.
Cool, we'll get back into it then.
Cool.
Point beyond square.
That extra
point. Is it back?
Yeah.
That's gone pretty square, just in front.
Two.
Yeah, I reckon so. It was this side of the yellow curve.
Yeah, cool. One wicket.
You don't think
mid-wicket's
got a chance to catch
it? No, it's gone. I reckon it's gone over it. You've hit it. What do you reckon, so it was 26 or yeah. 24, how are you feeling about it?
Yeah, not too bad. A bit annoying that I lost the wicket. I don't know what happened there, just a bit of scoreboard pressure really. I was just trying to hit that target and just play something that wasn't in my plan. But yeah, I thought it was okay. But at the end of the day, if you lose one wicket, you score 26 or 27, whatever it was. You're still going at nearly sevens, and it's quite easy to catch up later in the end. Yeah. I think the main thing as well needs to be thought about in that situation is the less chances you give the opposition to get you out, the more wickets you keep in the bank, the more runs you can go per over later on in the end.
Yeah,
that's what I'd say. So sevens is good, but six and a half, I think that's all right as well.
Yeah, perfect. That's what NS Doney tells guys, isn't he, in terms of taking it deep.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you're still there, it doesn't matter.
Exactly.
Got to run. Yeah, I like that. So what would you have done differently then? So if you do that scenario again, what would you look to do differently?
Maybe be a bit more innovative. Like I didn't even clock until halfway, as like I said, with the short third. So a lot more playing on line if it's down there at a quicker pace. Rather than just hitting it to the man for one, you've got more value if you just play a delicate little dab. So it's just being like smart in the areas that you know you can score it and you know where the value is. But I think I face too many doubles as well, that's a big thing. So if I did that again, I'd probably look to try and be more dynamic, use my feet more. And if I do get all the way out, where am I going to hit it? Thinking about that, rather than just coming down the track and not knowing what you're going to do and miss it. Just have a plan really, that's it.
I like it. And just from my sort of perspective, I think I was thinking there as a batter, which I felt helped. So even though you're just chucking balls, I feel like I got something out of it just by watching you.
Yeah.
Because then I'm going, right, how's he playing it? How do I need to bowl?
Absolutely.
Then when you're in that position.
Yeah.
Do you feel that as a spinner? Do you think you think like that?
When I'm bowling, I like to think, what area would I not want to hit the ball in if I was facing the spin? And for me, it's all, again, individual, depends on the individual who's batting. If you've got someone who sweeps well, then it's pretty simple. You bowl slower, a bit more flight, and you protect those areas. But in turn, if I was bowling to myself, I'd just take all the pace off it and just give me nothing to work with, basically. So thinking as, it works both ways. If you're batting, you think as a bowler, it helps just as much as a bowler thinking as a batter.
Yeah. Cool, brilliant.